Thank you very much. I won't keep you long because it's just the last one and it's just before drink, so the better to do it is the shorter. And I would invite you to a journey. To a journey because you are here at EXPONATEC in Cologne in Germany, and I will talk about our next general conference in Milan next year, July 2016. The museum professional community usually gather every 3 years. So this time it will be in Europe, but the next time in 2019, it will be in Japan, in Kyoto. And last time in 2013, it was in Rio, in Brazil. So I think it would be a good opportunity for our museum coming from Europe to take the lead of the discussion about what is going on, especially with the theme of museums and cultural landscape. Milan, of course, is a cosmopolitan creative city. I will not take too much time to present Milan. You will all dream about it. The conference venue, of course, is also a very famous one. And as you know, our program is sometimes a little bit tricky to understand where you are not familiar with ICOM. We have usually a lot of opening ceremony, closing ceremony, different venues that of course are related to museums, to monuments, as you can see here with the Castello, famous Castello, or the Michelangelo Pietà Rondanini. It's also usually with the closing party a unique number of social events. Why is it so important when we organize ICOM conference to have social events? Because it's always very important that in the city or even in the region where we meet, that all the museum can really show what they have and what they're doing. So it's really part of the world that for now it will be the one that will be focused. So this is Milan. This is the kind of schedule we're working on. You can imagine how sometimes complicated it appears. It's only because we have a lot of different committees that will meet. We also have a lot of different off-site meeting because we don't have to stay only in Milan. We can also go in the region and, for example, have a 1 day in Torino. We can also have special meetings with special committee. For example, SimSim is the committee from music instruments, and they will meet, of course, with us in the convention center, but they will also have a specific meeting within a specific museum, so they can discuss with representatives from around the world. Of course, we also have excursion day, Friday, this time, and then we have pre and post conference tours. Online registration is now open, and it's less expensive, of course, now, so please don't wait until the end to register. We also decided, like we did last time in Rio, to invite the chair of the international committees in Brescia and in Milan, end of November, so we can really discuss with them about the theme of the conference. We also have high-profile keynote speakers. We will also have major museum director that will plan round tables, and we of course organize and settle everything. I can tell you now that we secure the famous artist Christo and the famous Nobel Prize from Turkey. We also have a famous historian, philosopher, economist, and different ministry coming from different part of the world. This is, of course, for us very important because they will bring the subject of museum and culture and landscape during the opening ceremony and during the first day of the conference. What about the theme? Well, landscape is, as you know, different from country to another one. even when we discuss with our colleague in France, we don't translate it exactly the same way. Landscape, normally you will use the word paysage, but some will extend it even to heritage, which I think it's of course pushing a little bit too much. So even though we want to open the discussion on cultural landscape, I really think that we have to keep in mind that landscape, paysage, is not only the vision of what you will call a landscape as an urban or green landscape, but really as the community that you are in and that you see the transformation. So this is why with this topic we were able to think about cultural example, natural example of course, but also social dimension of the topic. And it is also very important to develop this subject when you are in Italy. As you know, Italy, with my colleague Alberto Garlandini likes to say, it's an open-air museum. You know how we can discuss about this notion of open-air museum, but it's for sure that when you are in Italy, you have this impression that you are in a kind of a museum, and sometimes the place to visit or the place to be inspired is not sometimes the museum, but just the piazza or the church or just the place where you are. So this is also why the topic of the conference was really related to the place and the community that will invite us as this situation, very special situation in Italy. We are also discussing among our network, not only about the recommendation as I refers to in my previous speech, but we are also discussing about the definition of museum. I know it seems sometime climbing a big hill, and some of my colleagues would ask, why do you open again the discussion about definition of museum, as we have several ones, but the ICOM one is the most important one and used one around the world. I know about, of course, the colleagues from UK or for America, there's slight difference, but our definition is the one that now is written in the recommendation at UNESCO. Why do we want to open the discussion? I really think that starting now, giving a first presentation in Milan, and I hope giving a full new definition in Kyoto during 2019, when it seems that it would be the year of Museum Science Center decided by UNESCO recently, we can follow the changes in museums. Open air museum, social world of museum, implementation of professionals. We all know that our world of museum is changing, and our definition is a definition that we can use, but sometimes we feel like there's some knowledge or some topics that are missing, and sometimes we still have to discuss about the different words that we're using. They're not as understandable as they should be between French, Spanish, English, and sometimes other language. So this is why we wanted to open the discussion, because also we've been pushed by some of our colleagues, especially coming from the contemporary art, when the borders between contemporary arts, galleries, and museum are not that easy to follow. We've been also asked by some government ministry from some different countries where they are they have an implementation of new law, and they definitely need our support and ICOM knowledge of the definition, so we can always really protect not only the museum but protect the professionals that work in the museum. What's the sense of protecting a museum if you don't have any more professional in the museum? So this is why we don't only want to promote the collection, but we want to promote the cultural and the natural heritage. Collection was also a huge debate during the 2 days of debate for the recommendation. Why? Because in a lot of countries, especially in Latin America, collections can exist without museum. Museums exist without collection. How can you protect a collection if you don't have a definition that interpret also the notion of collection? So this is also why we really have to take in mind and to take this in our thinking, that a collection means a specific object. Museums mean another one, but collection and museum doesn't mean the same. So we really have to work on this for the next, would say, years. So this is our conference website. I just would like to invite you to Milan. And before that, I hope I can invite you to get a drink after this 3 hours of wonderful presentation, very concrete museums and archive topics, and for ICOM, a very special time for a week when you can discuss and meet all of our colleagues. Thank you very much.